Do-do-do-do-do-do. What is going on, guys? My name is Felix and welcome to the video. Today we're going to talk a little bit about high street labels doing their sort of upmarket high fashion sort of attempt, and they sort of do these capsule collections. So in particular is going to be H&M Studio, especially for spring summer 18, and I'll also talk a little bit about Uniqlo U, which is Uniqlo's version of their like high fashion and affordable press, I guess. Uniqlo U is released, I think, twice a year as well, same as Studio for H&M, and they're really cool collections, both of them. I really like them. They kind of take high fashion and make them affordable. They normally bring in a higher-end designer or someone associated with a high-end label and get them to design a few pieces. Focusing more on like basic silhouettes, especially for Uniqlo U, is really cool to see like the different styles and fits that they can go for, especially on the menswear. I do like these short sleeve shirts that they do, and also the long sleeve shirts that Uniqlo U do. I haven't found the short sleeve ones anywhere. I don't think they're out yet, but I am very interested in picking those up. Moving on to Studio, the actual collection released this morning in store and last night online. They sold out very quickly online last night. I didn't manage to buy anything because I was busy, but I am going to run through a few of my favorite pieces as well as one that I picked up, which I'm probably going to get rid of. So for the jackets, there were two jackets in particular I really liked. The checkered overcoat, which is really, really cool. It's like black with blue and white checkerboard across it. Really, really nice, really simple, very lightweight. And when I saw it in store earlier, I really liked it. It's a good length and everything about it just works really well. The other jacket was the beige parka bomber. So on the inside it's got a little zip up bomber that's kind of attached to a parka. I really like this idea, it's really cool, kind of that two jacket in one, although the bomber isn't detachable at all. It's just kind of got that zip design on the inside. It's a light tan and it matches really well with black trousers especially, as well as some simple shoes, and it just kind of makes the outfit look really, really clean, and the way they've styled it on their lookbook is really cool. This entire collection is heavily inspired by Japanese fashion and Tokyo trends, I think they described it as. So the prints are very heavily inspired by Japanese writing, and you'll see that on a couple of the shirts. The first shirt is a black long sleeve with four pockets, two on either side. Really nice, really clean, simple. Love the design. Works really well. Didn't see it in store though, which is kind of weird. They also did two like short sleeve shirts, especially for the summer. The mustard color one with two pockets on each side of the chest. This kind of was in like a rougher cotton. It didn't really like the fit as well. Both shirts actually seem to have very long sleeves, which I didn't like. I'm usually a large and I probably should have taken a small when I would have picked them up. But because I tried on a large and I didn't have much time, I kind of left them there and I kind of regret that. But they do have an open like split at the top, so that kind of classic sort of Hawaiian shirt cut along the neck, which is really, really nice. And for the other one, which is a black with blue sort of designs over it, I think they've got Japanese writing across it in very, very big font, which you can't see, which is really cool because it's kind of a hidden design. This is made out of a different sort of cotton, is a lot softer and a lot more flowy. Again, the sleeves were ridiculously big and I should have taken a smaller size. For the bottoms, they also have a matching pair of shorts for that shirt, and it was really, really cool. I think the whole set would look really good. I didn't see the shorts as well, which is a bit weird. So I think they're gonna release more in the future. I'm not 100% sure though. Another pair of trousers were the belted trousers. I did actually pick these up, but I am going to get rid of them because I'm not a huge fan of them. And I do know someone who wants a pair. They fit very, very tight on the upper waist and they're very high waisted. They've got a very strong high rise and the belt is a very nice feature indeed. I really like the belt. However, I just think that the top kind of balloons out and it kind of reminds me of women's trousers, which I don't really like the look of. They kind of expand out and flare out at the top, which isn't really that sort of style that I like. Cut of them is really nice as well. They kind of taper in, which put me off a little bit. They do have a good length and I thought I could get a very nice like baggy oversized silhouette with it. However, it does taper in quite a bit at the bottom and I didn't realize, meaning it does just sit on top of shoes. Doesn't really drape over them as much. For the video here, I've styled them with a pair of Golf Le Fleur Converse, my yellow ones, because they're really, really clean. They look really good with it as well, especially when it's rolled down. But when you give it a three pin roll or sort of any roll or cuff, it looks really nice and it sits just above the shoe, which is a very, very cool effect, especially for the Golf Le Fleur, and kind of breaks up the difference in color between the trouser and the shoe. Apart from that, they've got two pockets on either side, some button pockets on the back, and they've got this cool belt loop at the back, which kind of covers half across like the back of the actual trousers, which is really, really cool. And I really like that. Definitely keeps it all in place. nice and secured on your body.
I've literally just got back to looking at the recording I've just done and realized that I didn't talk about the contrast stitch trousers, which are literally my favorite piece in the entire collection. So I'm just going to talk really quickly about them in this sort of setup, which is kind of BTEC, but who cares. So the contrast stitch are the nicest piece in my opinion, 100%. They're beautiful pieces, definitely cut with a straight fit. I would buy it, but I didn't see it yesterday, which is really annoying. They're beautiful, what can I say? Anyway, back to the normal rest of the video.
Some of the other trousers that I was interested in were the green ones. Again, I didn't see these, but they have a matching suit for this, which is kind of cool. I do wish they were a bit wider and kind of draped over a little bit more, but they do seem a little bit tapered. The same goes for the designed denim. They kind of did this frayed design camo sort of on it. They did a white and a black pair and a matching jacket as well. I don't know, I like the idea, but I just don't think it works. It wouldn't suit my style. If it was a wider fit, I think it'd work a lot better, but unfortunately I think it's a bit tapered, which isn't a bit too, I'm not too big of a fan of tapered denim. I do like a straight fit or slim fit, which kind of put me off this piece a little bit. I do think a lot of people will style it well, and I have to say in the lookbook they styled it exceptionally. In fact, the entire lookbook is styled very well, and I suggest you take a look at it. But anyway guys, that's what I thought of the H&M Studio Collection, as well as a little bit about Uniqlo U. Let me know if you copped any of the items down below. It's really cool. Great to see some feedback in comments as well. I love seeing your support. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you in the next video on Wednesday.